सब्सक्राइब करें तेजेंद्र इंग्लिश स्कूल चैनल को और उस बेल आइकन को दबाएं हमारे लेटेस्ट वीडियो लेक्चर सबसे पहले पाने के लिए।
टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न क्लास 8 सोशल साइंस गुजरात स्टेट बोर्ड बुक सेमेस्टर फर्स्ट चैप्टर नंबर 2 व्हाट इज अराउंड अस। ओके सो लेट्स बिगन द लेसन नंबर 2 ऑफ सोशल साइंस इन क्लास 8 what is around us. So the lesson will begin with the help of conversation in between son and mother. Okay. So Dhanvin was roaming in the garden with his mother. Who was roaming? Dhanvin in the garden. Okay. So while he was walking in the garden with his mother, so a question which came in his mind, so he asked to his mother. Okay, what question arose in his mind? What is land made up of? Okay, so the question which just came to Dhanvin's mind, what is land made up of? So his mother replied, do you see the sun every day? What he asked, do you see the sun every day? The sun too has a family which is known as the solar family. Okay, so his mother, Dhanvin's mother just replied to Dhanvin that however you can see the sun every day, it has two its family, okay, which is known as the solar family. Our earth is also one of the member of the solar family. The most important point is that only the earth among all the members of the solar family has got the suitable temperature, water, air to sustain living beings. Okay, so we can see within the solar system there are 8 planets. Okay, so before August 2006 there was 9 planets, but after August 2006 Pluto, which was considered as a dwarf planet and which was removed from the sun family or from the solar system, so at the presently we have only 8 planets, okay, in the solar system. So out of this all planets, okay, so here you can see all planets, Pluto also given, but which was considered as a dwarf planet, however it was considered by International Astronomical Union that the Pluto, which was a dwarf planet after 2006, so which was removed from the solar system. Okay, so here we can see there are total 8 planets presently. Okay, 8 planets. So out of this we need such a suitable environment, suitable atmosphere to live on the earth or to live at anywhere. Okay, even on Jupiter also we can live, but we can't have suitable environment, we can't have suitable air, water, okay, and temperature. So we can't able to live on Jupiter, Mars, Uranus, Neptune, Saturn, Venus, Mercury. Okay, but Earth has suitable environment, it has a suitable climatic condition in which the human being or the living being can live. Okay, so it has a suitable temperature, it has a water, it has air, which will support life on the earth. Generally, it is believed that part of sun which has been detached from the sun after the collision is earth. Okay, so at the first the sun, the whole solar system, which was one huge one single particle, okay, one single huge gases. Okay, so after broke this huge ball, this earth which separated from the sun. So at the time of its origin, it was in the form of a fireball. Okay, when it was origin, the earth was origin. So at that time earth was a fireball. This fireball started to cool down slowly. Okay, slowly our earth, which was started to cool down, many elements of the earth got transformed into liquid and further into solid form. Okay, so many elements, whatever the elements which were in the fireball, which is now Earth. So the many elements which are in the molten form, which transformed into liquid, into solid form, then during this process the elements which got transformed into solid are known as the lithosphere. Okay, so after collision, after cool down the elements of a fireball, the which elements which transformed into solid, which are known as the lithosphere. Okay, we will understand what is lithosphere. The element which got transformed into liquid are known as hydrosphere. And after transformation, after transformed, the element which transformed into liquid form, which are known as hydrosphere, and the element which transformed into gases, okay, so which came to be known as the atmosphere. Remember, okay, at the first Earth was one of the fireball. After collision or after cool down, such a different elements which start to transformed, some transformed into solid which are known as lithosphere, some into liquid which are known as hydrosphere, and some are in a gaseous form which are known as a atmosphere. Above all, the living world which developed due to land, water and air came to be known as a biosphere. Okay, so above all, which all? Hydrosphere, lithosphere and atmosphere, these above all, which developed due to land, water and air, came to be known as the biosphere. Okay, so it will support human life or any living being to live on the earth. In this way, the four spheres came into existence on the earth. Okay, so likewise it was formed. So here you can see again the picture of a solar system in which you can see the Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. Next one, the first one is lithosphere. Okay, so in this picture you can see lithosphere. So what is the meaning of lithosphere? We will see. So the sphere on which we live is known as the lithosphere. Okay, at which, where we are living, on the lithosphere. Now what is the meaning of lithosphere? Litho means rock. What is the meaning of litho? Rock. And sphere means layer. Okay, layer of rock. The upper layer of the earth is made up of soil and solid material like rock. Okay, upper layer on the earth surface which made up of what materials? Like solid materials and soil. Approximately 29% of the surface of the earth is covered with lithosphere. Remember, okay, on the earth the lithosphere or the land which is covered around 29%. Okay, this layer is almost 64 kilometer to 100 kilometer thick. Okay, so if we'll, this one is a surface of the earth. For example, this one is surface of the earth, and if we'll go till 64 to 100 kilometer, so till there we can see this first layer lithosphere. Okay, the thickness of the lithosphere is not the same everywhere on the earth. Okay, so we can't able to see that from earth surface to till 100 kilometer the thickness of a lithosphere. Somewhere we can see only 10 kilometers also, 20 kilometers also, 30 kilometers, 64 kilometers, 100 kilometers also. So which is the thickness which is different to every places. The thickness on the lithosphere is not same everywhere on the earth. Similarly, their interior and exterior do not have identical physical features. Okay, so that's why we can't able to see the same physical feature on the earth surface. Somewhere we can see mountains, somewhere plain areas, somewhere plateaus, somewhere valleys. Okay, so different physical features we can see on the earth surface. So it is most made up of substances like soil and a rock. Okay, so the earth surface or physical features which totally made up of substances like a soil and rock. Out of a soil and rock, the upper layer or the physical features which was a made up of. Now, landforms like mountains, plateaus, plains, and valleys are seen on the lithosphere. Yes, we can see this all landforms on the lithosphere like mountains, plateau, plains, and a valley. The temperature increases as we move towards the center of the earth. The molten rock in the interior of the earth are known as a magma. Okay, however, we will move towards the center of the earth, in between the center of the earth. So the temperature which will be increasing, okay, and the earth, the molten rock in the interior of the earth, which are known as a magma. Okay, while we will go in the earth interior, so there will be magma, okay, which means molten material. There are many gases present in the interior of the earth which rise up with pressure and heat. Okay, so if we'll see, so in this earth, just I'll take one piece of the earth, okay, which means this one is earth. Just we'll take this one piece, this one is a center. So the pressure of rock, the pressures of rocks of the surface of the earth is equally strong. There are many gases present in the interior of the earth which rise up with pressure and heat. So in this center, we can see there are many gases which will give pressure to the upper layer. Okay, so we all know here crust, mantle, and here core. So this one, all the gases which will force to the lithosphere to comes up. Okay, so it will pressure and give generating a heat, but the pressure of rocks of the surface of the earth is equally, okay, the pressure of from here and the pressure from here, which is equally, okay. So this magma, they can't able to comes out because the lithosphere also strong as the magma are strong. Thus balance between the two is maintained, okay, because of the same strength, the balance in between this both, which means balance between the magma and balance between the lithosphere, which is maintained. So the crust of the earth does not break. Okay, so the crust or the first layer, okay, crust, this one here mantle, and here core, this one last core. So here it will give pressure to the lithosphere or to the crust. So the force or the strength of this both is same, so it is not break. When the balance between two is not maintained, the crust breaks and a volcano erupt. So at sometimes we can see such at some places volcanic eruption. Why? Because there is no any kind of maintenance of crust and magma. Okay, so they will give pressure, and here the crust which is not strong as a magma. Okay, so at that place we can see the volcanic eruption. Okay, so now we'll come back to the conversation in between the mummy and his son. Now his son is asking to his mummy, what he is asking, mummy, how is the lithosphere useful to us? What he was he is asking, how is the lithosphere useful to us? So she replied, where can we construct our house if the lithosphere is not there? Just imagine, okay, if lithosphere is not there, so where can we build our house? Where can we construct our house? Okay, that's not possible. In the air we can't able to construct our house, in the water it's not possible. Okay, so without lithosphere, how can we go get water to drink, agriculture for food, mineral for industries and forest. So without lithosphere it's not possible to get water to drink, okay, but there will be not life, okay, without lithosphere. We people can't able to live without lithosphere. So how can we get water to drink, agriculture for food, totally agricultural activities which done on the lithosphere? Yes, so which is difficult or not possible without lithosphere. Then minerals for industries and forest. So minerals also we need, okay, at presently mostly we are using minerals, so which we can get from the lithosphere. And forest, okay, forest also we can see on the lithosphere. Now you has to work on it, on what? Draw a picture depicting all the details you observe on lithosphere based on our conversation, okay. So what pictures you have to draw in this paragraph given, like water to drink, agriculture for food, mineral industry, forest, then some points are here, mountains, plateau, plains, valleys, okay. So which you have to draw on one page, in which you have to include this all elements, this all things like mountains, plateaus, plains, valleys, then some agricultural fields, then minerals, forest areas, okay. So that's your work. Now here we completed the lithosphere, okay. Lithosphere, which means what? A layer of a rock. Now next one, hydrosphere. Now let me talk to you about hydrosphere. The hydrosphere is the liquid component of the earth, okay. Hydrosphere is in the liquid. Is it includes the oceans, seas, lakes, ponds, rivers and streams, okay. So hydrosphere, what all things will comes under the hydrosphere? So oceans, seas, lakes, ponds, rivers and streams. On the surface of the earth, the area of water is more than that of a land. On the surface of the earth, the area of water which is more than that of land. For example, so in the lithosphere, what we studied? So lithosphere will cover around 29% earth surface, okay. So here we can see that 71% of earth surface which was covered by hydrosphere, okay, remember it, okay. Lithosphere 29% and hydrosphere 71%. A water body in hydrosphere that carries a huge amount of water is known as the ocean, okay. We all know there are total 5 ocean, yes. So which will the water body which will have a huge amount of water, not only small amount of water, huge amount of water, which is known as the oceans. These oceans are the, here given 4 oceans, okay, but I will tell which one is this fifth one. These oceans are the Pacific Ocean. The first one is Pacific Ocean, then second one is the Atlantic Ocean, the third one is the Indian Ocean, and the fourth one is the Arctic Ocean, okay. So Arctic Ocean, which we can see in the North Pole, okay, North Pole we can see the Arctic Ocean, and Atlantic Ocean, then Pacific Ocean and Indian Ocean, which we can see. So just I'll try to draw here one map of world, okay, of the world. So we can see here Europe, here Asia, then here Africa, here Australia, here North America and South America, here Antarctica, okay. So Arctic Ocean, which is here, what is it? Arctic Ocean. Then if you'll come to this side, here Pacific Ocean, and here this side also Pacific Ocean, okay, got it. Now the next one, Arctic Ocean is here, here Pacific Ocean, here also Pacific Ocean, here Atlantic Ocean, and here after India, here Indian Ocean. So the combination of Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, and Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, and Indian Ocean will form here Southern Ocean. Which one ocean? Southern Ocean. Okay. So all these oceans are connected with each other. Okay, no one's ocean which is separate from other ocean. Okay, all are connected each other. The water bodies close to the land are known as. Okay, so we all know that after here Bay of Bengal. So here water body which will close nearby the land. Okay, nearby this land which are known as what? Some different names given to this all: seas, bays, straits, gulf, etc. Okay, the oceans of the earth are huge and deep. We all know that the oceans which are huge and deep, valleys with depth of 10 to 11 kilometers are located at their bottom. Okay, some valleys which are located in their bottom, which has their depth of 10 to 11 kilometers. Remember, the ocean bed has similar features like that of the surface of the earth. It has high mountains, plateaus, vast plains, valleys, etc. Whatever the physical features we can see on the lithosphere, same physical features are located in the water bodies. Okay, inside the water, inside the oceans. Okay, which are huge mountains which also are located inside the water in the oceans. Plateaus are located inside of the water or inside of the oceans. Plateaus are located, vast plains are located, valleys are located. So all these physical features which are located inside the oceans, okay, inside the water bodies. Now mummy, how much water will be there in the seas? Since sea water is salty, is it useful to us? Okay, so here again son asking to his mummy that how much water will there in the seas. Okay, what is the amount of water in the seas, and the water of the seas which is salty, so how can we use it? Is it useful to us? Okay, so his mummy is replied to his son that yes, oceans contains 97% of the total amount of water on the earth. Yes, out of this all total amount of the earth, the total amount of the water on the earth, oceans covered 97% water. Okay, approximately 1/3 of remaining water is trapped in the ice caps and glaciers. Okay, 1/3, which means out of this 97% or out of this whole water, 1/3, which means out of this one amount of water which is trapped in the ice caps on the mountains, glaciers at the mountains and poles. So some water is accumulated in the lakes and some flows in the rivers, and some is stored in the interior of the earth as the groundwater. Okay, so remember how the water which is distributed to the different areas, like on as ice caps, glaciers also there is a water, then such other water bodies are accumulated through lakes, then through rivers, through ponds, then the interior water like groundwater. The amount of potable fit for drinking water is less. Okay, we have very less amount of fresh water. Fresh water is precious. Okay, we can't able to drink water from oceans. Okay, we need fresh water to drink. We can't able to drink salty water from the oceans, from the sea. Okay, so which is a precious, which is a important for us. So this fresh water is required by living beings for their existence. Okay, whatever the living beings we can see on the earth, so they need fresh water for their living, for their existence on the earth. The moisture for rain, which is the main source of fresh water, comes from the oceans only. Okay, so every year we are receiving rainfall, so which comes from oceans only. Okay, which is not comes from rivers and ponds. Okay, so we all know about the hydrological cycle. Okay, evaporation, condensation and precipitation. Again it will run back to the oceans, again from oceans evaporation, then cloud formation, condensation, then again precipitation and rain. So valuable chemical mineral, salt, fishes, etc. are found in the seas. Such minerals also we can find from the seas. Salt also can found, it can be get from seas. Fishes also can be found from the seas. As we have living organisms on the land, in the same way the seas and oceans have aquatic life inside them. Okay, so as on the earth we can see there are many living beings like humans, animals, plants, then insect. Okay, so likewise we can see different living beings in the oceans also. Okay, so the tremendous force of waves, tidal and currents of oceans are potential source for generating electricity. Okay, which is important for generating electricity. What is important? Waves and tides and currents of oceans. With the help of this all we can generate electricity. Besides, these oceans are also useful as a waterways. Okay, if suppose we has to go from India to European countries, from India to Africa, from India to Southeast countries, so we can go to that all places with the help of waterways. Okay, so in this picture what you can see, what would happen if there were no seas? Just think, if there are no seas on the earth, so what will happen? If there is no water, so what will happen? Okay, there is not possibility of a human being or for any living beings. So here one activity is given: locate using various colors the oceans, seas, bays and straits in the world map given above. Okay, so in this map what you have to do, just use different various color for oceans, for seas, bays and straits, and just highlight these all areas. Okay, like oceans, seas, bays and straits. Okay, so that's your work. This one is your activity which you have to do. Now let's understand the third sphere, atmosphere. The sphere of air that wraps the earth from all sides is called atmosphere. Okay, atmosphere, which means what? For example, this one is the earth. Okay, so atmosphere which will cover, or which is, this one is the atmosphere. So around the earth we can see one layer. Okay, from 0 to 1600 kilometers, so which is known as, which means this one layer which is surrounded by the earth is known as the atmosphere. It extends approximately up to 1600 kilometers from the surface of the earth. Okay, so if you will see the surface of the earth, so from here surface we can see till 1600 kilometers. Okay, how many kilometers? 1600 kilometers. So it cannot be seen clearly with the naked eye, like lithosphere and hydrosphere. Okay, so hydrosphere and lithosphere we can see, but atmosphere we can't able to see. Okay, just we can experience. Atmosphere is composed of various gases, water vapors, dust particles, smoke, salt, microorganisms, etc. Okay, now remember, atmosphere which composed which made up of the various gases, different gases which are included within the atmosphere. Then water vapors also are included within the atmosphere, then dust particles, then smoke, salt and different microorganisms. Atmosphere is colorless. We can't able to see the color of atmosphere. Okay, it has no color. Then odorless. Okay, odorless, which means we can't able to hold it, or we can't able to just see the directly. Okay, and transparent, which means some mirrors from which we can see from one side to another side, transparent. Okay, so likewise the atmosphere is so solid, liquid and gaseous elements are included in the atmosphere. Okay, what elements are included within the atmosphere? Solid also are there, liquid also are there, and gaseous elements also are there in the atmosphere. It contains approximately, the main composition of gases are 78% nitrogen in the atmosphere, 21% is oxygen, and 0.03% is carbon dioxide, and the remaining is the other gases. Okay, when we go higher from the surface of the earth, the amount of most of the gases in the atmosphere decreases. Okay, which means whatever the gases we can see, experience on the earth surface while we are going in the atmosphere, okay, in the higher, so the amount of carbon dioxide, the amount of oxygen, the amount of nitrogen, which will be decreases. Carbon dioxide gas is heavy, so it is found more in the lower layer of the air. Okay, so carbon dioxide, which is a heavy, okay, so which we can found near the lower layer of the earth. Ozone gas comprises of a very small proportion in the air. Ozone layer, which is one of the important layer on the atmosphere, so which has a very small proportion. This gas absorbs the ultraviolet rays from the sun and protects the earth from excessive heat of sun. Okay, so just this one is earth, and here we can see this one is one layer, which is ozone layer. Okay, and here sun, so we are receiving sunlight, but the sunlight without ozone layer, which are harmful to the earth. Okay, not only to the human, but which is harmful to the earth. So this ozone layer, which will protect the earth from this all ultraviolet rays. Okay, which means it will absorb, the ozone layer which will absorb this all ultraviolet rays, and whatever the sun rays which we need, that we are receiving. Okay, because of this ozone layer. Okay, so which will protect the earth from excessive heat and excessive heat of the sun. This gas is more in proportion in the morning in the open ground and in the air near the seas. Okay, so the ozone gas, which we can see which has more at the time period of morning, at the morning time, sunrise time, and nearby the sea. So here given here the composition of atmosphere. Okay, main gases, oxygen, nitrogen and other gases. Gases like oxygen and nitrogen keeps the living creatures on the earth alive. Nitrogen reduces the intensity of oxygen. Okay, so gases just like oxygen and nitrogen keeps the living creature on the earth alive. Because of oxygen and nitrogen, we can see the living creatures on the earth. Okay, just think, oxygen will be not there on the earth surface. So while we are breathing, which one gas we are just taking? Oxygen. Okay, if oxygen will be not there, so how can, it's not possible for human being. So nitrogen reduces the intensity of oxygen. Water is the most important component in the atmosphere. Okay, we all know that water is the most important. Due to heat, the water in the form of water vapor evaporates and mixes with air, which is known as a moisture. Okay, so due to heat, due to the high temperature, the water from the water bodies, which will form of in the form of a very vapor evaporates and which will mix with the air, which is known as a moisture. The process of cooling of vapor is called a condensation. Okay, while this water vapors which will be goes higher in the atmosphere and it will be cooling, which is known as which is called a condensation. Various forms of mist moisture like dew, fog, clouds and precipitation are due to condensation. Okay, so in the condensation we can see many different moistures like dew, fog, clouds, and so the effects of atmosphere is seen on human beings in every aspect of life, such as in their food habits, clothing, habitat, color, economic activities, etc. Okay, so the effect of the atmosphere, we can see it will affect totally to the human beings. How? For example, the atmosphere at the polar areas, polar region, which is totally different from the areas nearby the equator. Okay, so here nearby the polar region, the peoples, they will be wearing woolen clothes, as in the equator the people will wearing the cotton clothes. Why? Because here more heat and at the polar region there is a cold. Okay, so likewise it will affect then economic activities also will be different, clothing also, habitat also, color also, food habits also. Okay, so all things will be affected by the atmosphere. Many dust particles are seen in the atmosphere. Spreading of sun rays are visible due to these particles. Okay, so in the atmosphere there are many different particles, dust particles. So because of that we can see the spreading of the sun rays, it is due to the dust particles that is not, it does not suddenly turn dark after the sunset, and is it does not suddenly turn bright after the sunrise. Okay, so at the morning time we can see, so the earth and here sun. For example, now earth is rotating in this direction. Okay, so the sun rays are falling here, sun rays are falling here, but till this area which will be not facing direct sunlight, even here we can see the morning time the lights comes. Okay, why? Because in this atmosphere we can see different particles, dust particles, because of which the sun rays which falls on this dust particles which will reflect to these areas, and the area nearby this will be having light. Okay, before morning time. So same at the sunset time also, the sun rays are reflected back with the help of these dust particles on the surface of the earth, and we receive the light of the sun. Okay, as I told, we are able to listen to the sounds due to the presence of atmosphere. Because of atmosphere only we can see, we can listen the sound from others. Okay, because of atmosphere you can listen the sound which I am speaking. That is why radio and Doordarshan telecast is possible. Okay, in which in the atmosphere or in the air the radio waves which are traveling and which will comes to us. So in this picture what is given? Human life and spheres. Okay, so what you have to think, on the basis of which experiences can you say, can you state that the atmosphere exists on the surface of the earth? on the base of what you can see, on the base of what you can see that the atmosphere is there on the earth. Okay, you have to think and has to answer it in the comment box. Now in this picture, what you can see, what you can observe here, atmosphere, because of atmosphere this man can work on the computer. Okay, then here hydrosphere, here drinking water, and here maybe the field, here biosphere. Okay, here we can see a cow, human here also, and this one said lithosphere. Because of lithosphere, here we can see the road which is constructed and buildings which were constructed. So now the next one, biosphere, okay, which is an important sphere on the earth surface, which is possible because of the previous three spheres. Which three? Lithosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere. The part of lithosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere where the living world exists is known as a biosphere. Okay, so here this one lithosphere, here hydrosphere, and atmosphere. So where three are meets at here at the small portion. So this one layer is known as what? Biosphere. Biosphere is one of the important sphere of the earth. Earth is the only planet in the solar system having a biosphere, because of which human being or any living beings can live. Biosphere includes vegetation, animal, insect, and human beings. We obtain food and many other necessary things from a biosphere. So whatever the things which we are eating, which we can see because of biosphere, many other necessary things which we can get because of the biosphere, we cannot live without vegetation and animals. Yes, okay, that's true. Okay, we can't live without vegetation, without a food, without trees, without forest, without animals. Biosphere is the base of our existence and living. Okay, it is divided into two parts. Biosphere is divided into two parts, non-living and living. Okay, non-living also known as abiotic, and living also known as a biotic. Lithosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere form the non-living part, while lithosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere, which will form non-living part of the biosphere, and while other side, plants, animals, and microorganisms, human beings, which are included in the living world, okay, which are known as a biotic elements. Now here one question which given, you have to think, if any element in the living world is destroyed, so then what will be its effect on your lives? For existence, what happen if the birds are wiped out from the face of the earth? Okay, for example, totally the birds which we can see around us, which will be wiped out, okay, which will be died, or because of any reason the birds will be not there, it will be removed from the atmosphere or from the earth. So is there any effect of that on human life or on our life? So you have to write it in the comment box, this one question answer. So in this picture you can see the components of a biosphere. In the biosphere, what all things will be included? So natural things also will be included, man-made things also will be included, people also will be included within the component of the biosphere. Okay, now here we can see effects of human activities on a sphere, how it is affected on the spheres. Okay, so we can see here atmosphere, here hydrosphere, and here lithosphere. Because of that we can see biosphere. Okay, biosphere, which means here these birds will be getting water also, they will be using this lithosphere also, then the human, they can use air also, they can use water also, and they are using field, okay, which means lithosphere also. Now, human beings knowingly and unknowingly undertake many activities for their development. We all know that human action causes an imbalance in the different spheres. Due to this, the balance of various spheres is threatened. Okay, which means knowingly or unknowingly, the people they are undertaking the different activities for their own development, for the economical purposes or for other purposes for living beings. So, which will sometime it will create or it will cause imbalance in between this all different spheres. Due to this, the balance of various spheres is threatened. Okay, which is threatened, which means what? Dangerous for the whole spheres. Underground nuclear testing, too much drilling for mineral oil, and excessive drilling of tube wells affect the lithosphere and cause an imbalance. Okay, so the activities which undertaken by the people, like a nuclear testing, too much drilling for mineral oil, then excessive drilling of tube wells, which will affect this lithosphere totally, and which will cause an imbalance of the lithosphere. The dumping of waste from village and cities along with industrial waste into the water bodies pollute them. Okay, which means here there is the harmful for the water bodies. Okay, what is the harmful for the water bodies? Dumping of waste from villages and cities. Okay, whatever the huge waste which gathered by the peoples, which is dumped outside from the city, okay, which will pollute, or the outside from the city in the river, which will pollute water. Okay, so the polar caps have started melting due to increasing heat. However, because of the this cold at the polar region, North Pole and Southern Pole, we can see, and on the high mountains we can see this ice caps. Okay, now slowly the temperature which is increasing, the heat which is increasing, because of that this all ice caps which are start to melting. Okay, so the oil spills from ships and disposal of industrial and chemical waste into the water cause the destruction of marine life, which is highly dangerous for the hydrosphere. Okay, which means oil spilling in the from ships. Okay, sometimes we can see such a leakage from the ships, very huge or large ships, disposal of industrial waste, chemical waste into the water bodies, that cause the destruction of marine life. The marine life, which means the fishes which can't able to live in the oceans, in the seas, because of the pollution. Okay, which is totally harmful or totally dangerous for the hydrosphere. Harmful gases emitted by industries, workshops, power station and vehicles pollute air. Okay, the areas with the higher frequency of vehicles saw increased rate of carbon dioxide in the air. However, the peoples that using the vehicles, because of which we can see the carbon monoxide, which is creating, and the amount of CO2 is the in the air is increasing due to the cutting of trees. Okay, so we all know CO2, which means carbon dioxide. Because of this carbon dioxide, the temperature which will be increasing, heat on the earth increasing is due to increase in CO2 in the air. In this way, human activities affect the biosphere. Okay, so heat of the earth which increases due to in the CO2 in the air. Okay, however, carbon dioxide will increase. It is a heavy and hot gas, okay, carbon dioxide. So however, it will increase, the temperature also will be automatically increases in the atmosphere. So which is which will affect the totally biosphere. The nurturing links of nature are endangered due to the exploitation of environment, which endangers the biosphere. Okay, the nurturing links of nature, which is danger ड्यू टू द एक्सप्लोटेशन ऑफ एनवायरमेंट. टोटली द पीपल्स दे आर एक्सप्लोइटिंग द एनवायरमेंट फॉर देयर ओन पर्पसेस. ओके, विच इज टोटली डेंजर फॉर द बायोस्फीयर, टोटल बायोसिस्टम. ओके, सो विच इज अबाउट द बायोस्फीयर. सो आई होप यू ऑल अंडरस्टैंड दिस लेसन नंबर सेकेंड. If you have any doubt, just write your doubts in the comment section. I will try to solve it. Thank you for